You want to know how not to diagnose familial hypercholesterolemia? You don't look for signs. Yes, signs do happen. It's called xanthelasma. We've covered this in other places. These white pockets under the skin, they're actually deposits of cholesterol. You don't want to do that because you're going to miss the vast majority of people that have hypercholesterolemia. Now, here's a question. How important is hypercholesterolemia anyway? You know, if you ask 90, 95% of docs, they'll say cholesterol is the biggest risk factor. It's not. You ask some other docs, like Nir Ali on YouTube, and he'll say, no, you want to have healthy, high LDL. You know, it's not that simple on either side of the issue. Yes, prediabetes, diabetes does appear to be by far the biggest risk factor for heart attack and stroke, and most of that's undiagnosed. Well, guess what? Familial hypercholesterolemia, genetic hypercholesterolemia, is a risk factor as well. Not nearly as big, not nearly as common, and not nearly as much of a problem when it does happen. Now, this comes from the FH website, Familial Hypercholesterolemia website. They do a good job of explaining things like heterozygous and homozygous. And if you're interested, heterozygous means you just got one from your mom, but not from your dad, or vice versa. But you didn't get it from both parents, like homozygous. There's a problem with that. That is implied but inaccurate simplicity. You see, the reality is there are over 1,200, between 1,200 and 2,000 separate individual genetic variations that can lead to familial hypercholesterolemia. So another thing that the FH Foundation says is that 90% of us who have FH don't know it. Once you start realizing the total number of genetic variations, it becomes very clear. It's far more than 90% of us that have this problem don't know it. Another thing you have to ask is it 2.5 times the risk or 10 times the risk or somewhere in between? I would say there's a lot more people where it's even less than 2.5 times the risk. But again, that gets into some conjecture, and let's don't even go there. One thing we do need to realize, though, is that we haven't clarified yet the fact that there are multiple risk factors for heart attack and stroke. Risk factors like atrial fib, risk factors like obesity, risk factors like, by far the biggest one, insulin resistance, many of which are undiagnosed, like insulin resistance, like atrial fib, like familial hypercholesterolemia. Now, Sue was a great example of how it's the combination of risk factors that's the problem. In her mid-30s, she had a problem. She had to have quintuple bypass. She was smoking in addition to her FH. She stopped smoking, was fine for another 20 years. Then she had to have another bypass because she gained 125 pounds. She lost that 125 pounds. Lost the prediabetes, diabetes that went along with it. She's over 70 now and doing very well. So here's the thing we need to remember. It's not just one risk factor, and especially with FH, it's not just one risk factor. One of the things that we'll find out as we get deeper into the cardiogenetics courses is that even with genes, it's which combinations create lethal combinations. For example, the heart attack gene, 9p21, the ninth chromosome, the p21 area. It has a unique combination with FH in terms of increasing risk for heart attack and stroke. We've barely touched the surface on understanding things like 9p21 and FH. Now when you put them together, it's just terra incognita, unknown territory for us. Thank you for your interest. Why wait for a disease and hope for a cure? I used to be an ER doc. My name is Ford Brewer. I quit ER after a few years because it was just so frustrating. Most of the things bringing people into the ER are things that should have been prevented, including heart attack, stroke, number one cause of death, number one cause of permanent disability. People think that you're just going to have those and that they're not predictable. Both of those are wrong. They are predictable, and you don't have to have them. Usually it's lifestyle. Lifestyle is more important than supplements and even prescription drugs and even stents and surgery. But the current times are tough. Major financial impact with the lockdowns that most states have been going through. We've been working on a way to make this much more affordable with a subscription process. And that's exactly what we're announcing today. We've got two levels. One is the Silver membership, where you get access to our courses, a private webinar each month, and access to our supplement store and supplement recommendations and prescription. Or I would suggest even more so, the Gold membership. You can get a script for a freestyle Libre and find out what your blood sugar metabolism's doing on a daily basis. And you can get a lab order for inflammation, OGTT, and insulin survey. You can also get a 30-minute one-on-one with me. So I'm looking forward to seeing you. Cost is no longer an excuse. So if you're interested, go to go.prevmedheartrest.com/prevmed-subscription or call us at 859-721-1414, 859-721-1414, or email us at myhealth@prevmedheartrest.com. Looking forward to seeing you. Thank you.